Hello guys, how are you doing? Henry here, back with another video. So in January 2016, I decided to quit my job and start my own business. Man, that was quite a ride and I didn't have anything to my name, but I just said, you know what, let me do this and see where it goes. So now 5 years later, you know, celebrated 5 years in business, you know, at the end of February. And it was an exciting time. So I just thought that I would come here and share with you guys, you know, 5 important lessons that I have learned in these 5 years of business. So you guys know that on my channel, my passion is to inspire you to reach your personal and career goals. And one of the ways that I like to do this is by having, you know, discussions like these, you know, with you guys, or interviewing, you know, people who have made it in their careers, in their businesses, you know, CEOs of banks, CEOs of multi-million dollar businesses, you know, entrepreneurs as well. You know, those are my favorite, bankers, professionals, you know, who have managed to make it to at the top of their careers, so that, you know, we can hear their stories and inspire each other and get lessons on how to actually win, you know, in this life and win in what we believe that we are called to do. So guys, 5 years ago, I decided to quit my job and start my own labor law consultancy. And one of the things that they say here in South Africa is that half of all the businesses, you know, that get started fail in their first year. And in the second year, half of those which have survived will also fail. So this is a statistic that was in the back of my mind the whole time, but I just kept going nonetheless. So guys, without any further ado, the 5 lessons that I learned, you know, let's get into that now. So number one, lesson number one is only go into business that you understand. Yeah, so when I quit my business, my job, I had been in that industry for over 2.5 years. So I knew exactly, you know, how, you know, my company was getting clients and how they were servicing them and how they're getting the money. So those are 3 important questions that you need to ask yourself before you get into business. You know, do you know how to get clients in that space? Number one, do you know how to service them? And number three, do you actually know how to get your money once the work has been done? Because guys, if you're not securing the bag, there's no point in working. There's no point. It's just an academic exercise. So you need to know, you know, what instruments are you going to use? You know, what avenues are you going to use to actually get your money back? You know, or get money which someone owes you. So whether these are legal instruments, you know, whatever, how you're going to do it, but you need to know how you're going to do it. If you've actually listened to some of my videos, you know, you know that I lost over $1,000, you know, last year getting into a business deal and into an industry that I didn't understand. I didn't know how these people were promising heaven and earth, but I didn't know how I was going to get my money back if it didn't work. And, you know, that failed. And that's exactly an example right there. Get into things that you understand, into investments that you actually have got control over, because you need to know how you're going to get your money back, your nest egg. How are you going to get it back if things don't work out? So that's lesson number one. Lesson number two, guys, you need to know that this is going to take longer than you think. Yes, it's going to take longer than you think, and you have to be prepared to go the distance. You know, that's what's going to happen. So what is most important is that when you have decided that you're going to go into business, yes, you've got your business plan. Yes, you've got your projections. Yes, you've got, you know, what you have planned, that things are going to go down this way. But it might not happen the way you think. Matter of fact, most people I know will tell you that, you know, things don't really work out the way you have actually projected them to work out. That's just the nature of the beast. That's the nature of the game. But you need to be prepared that no matter what happens, I'm going to keep at it. So you're going to need focus. You're going to need a positive attitude. That's what you're going to need to sort of, you know, go through those rainy days, to identify the opportunities. Because it's all about identifying opportunities. Business, that's what business is about. So if you are not in a good space, you're going to miss most of those opportunities. Focus is going to be important. You're going to be tempted to get into a lot of things when things don't start working out, or even when they are working out. But keep the main thing, and focus on what you really want to achieve and what you have set out to achieve at the end of the day. So that's number two. Number three, guys, is that you need to be able to adjust things if they are not working. Be flexible. Business is all about continuous improvement. If something is not working, tweak it. You know, your marketing strategy is not working. You know, your Google Ads, whatever you use is not working, tweak it. Your website is no longer working, tweak it, improve it. That's the only way that you can get to the next level. So don't be set in your ways. Always be flexible, always be willing to change your strategy, and you're surely going to win, because that's what the game is about. And number four, guys, you need the right partners in business. So one thing about partnership, guys, partnership is all about sharing in profits and losses. So you need people that are going to increase your profits and lower your losses. That means that you cannot just get anybody to be your partner. It's not about being friends or relatives, but it's about who can get the job done, who can add the most value. You know, that's what a partner is, or that's what partners are there for, to add value. So this is not just a good employee. This is beyond a good employee, because this is a partner. And that's what you need to do. You know, there's an African proverb which says, you know, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go further, go together. You know, that's what it actually says. It means let's, you know, go with people who are like-minded, who are putting the same effort as you, adding the same value, who actually know what it's about. You know, that's what you need to do. And number five, guys, be flexible with regards to your costs. So do not commit to long-term fixed costs. You do not need high long-term fixed costs. You know, right now it's so awesome with technology that we've got so many different, options. You know, you have virtual offices these days. You know, you can have a scanner on your phone. You don't need to buy all these things. You don't have to laden yourself with getting, you know, an office, brick and mortar, when you can actually be flexible. So that's just one example, but there are many more other examples. You know, do not lock yourself in to high fixed term costs, which are over a long period. Because when things happen in business, those costs are always going to be there, whether your revenue is low or high, and that might actually kick you out of business and frustrate you when it didn't have to. So always remember, keep your costs low when you're getting in. You know, keep things like salaries low. You know, you can always, you know, keep your costs low, you know, and you can always, you know, recoup that when you do your dividends and things like this. And just for your bonus, guys, number six is, you know, connect your business to your spirituality. This has to be bigger than yourself. It has to be bigger than yourself. You know, when things get tough, you need a strong why to keep going, man. I believe that I've been called to be a kingdom financier, and commerce or business is just a vehicle for that. So I always remind myself, when things get tough, I always remind myself of my why. You know, that's going to be important. When things get tough, remember your why. That's what's going to keep you going, and that's what's going to make you last. So guys, man, thank you for taking your time to listen. Hope this was helpful. If you got some value out of this video, you know, hit the like button, subscribe, share this video right now, hit that bell notification so you can know the next time that I go online and start another video. So guys, in the next 5 years, the plan is always, it's just going to be to grow, to expand, you know, grow teams, recruit, go into other areas, you know, other cities in this country. And yeah, we'll see where it goes and have a real business, make it a business concern. You know, a business is, you know, they say there's a difference between, you know, being self-employed and being a business owner. A business owner, you know, can be at home and the thing can just be running. So guys, let's keep on dreaming. Let's keep pushing. Love you. God bless. And we'll see you on the next video. Cheers. Bye.